An exciting new announcement from SmartSuite. We can now create documents from our SmartSuite data, information that we store in SmartSuite. We can create those documents automatically. No longer do we have to go in and manually create something from a template. We can do it all from an automation now, store that PDF back in our database solution, or even share it externally via email. If you want to learn more about this awesome new automation feature, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools. And I've got to say, before we get into the actual guts and example here, this is one of those features that for almost as long as this channel has been here, people have been asking for this. How do I create a document through an automation using the data that I keep in my no-code database? Surprisingly, no other software allows for this feature except for SmartSuite. It is now possible to do it all in one place without using third-party tools to create those PDFs and automations. All in one place, and that place is SmartSuite. If you have not yet signed up for SmartSuite, please consider doing so with our affiliate link. It's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. Now to get started here, I'm gonna pop on into my screen. I am starting with a template that I just installed from the SmartSuite universe of templates. If you want to get access to this, I will share the link to this particular orders and invoicing template wherever you found this video so that you can start where I am right now. Now at a high level, we've got customers. We have the customer information here with an email, with the phone number, with the address on file, and we can even store their logos. We've got invoices here, and the invoices are actually linked to orders. So the orders, you can see we have three different ones. Each order is connected to a customer and also connected to a delivery. And then, as I mentioned as well, the invoices are linked up to these orders also, and we're creating invoices for the different items that we've sold here. Now, I want to first do a little bit of expansion on this template before we get into the actual document design. And the reason for that is it used to be best practice to kind of create this sub item element here. So there's this thing called items, and it's a sub items field type in SmartSuite. And you can see these are the fields that are permitted or are included in this sub item. So it's like a linked relationship inside of here. If we dive into this record for items one, right here, it's like a table within a table, right? We can see that we sold this, we sold four of them, and here's the price. Now the issue with this that I have is that I can't create a formula field inside of here. So if I type formula F-O-R, you'll see I can't add that field here. And I wanna be able to create something that says, hey, this is the price of this item, 244. We sold four of them, and so we know how much that is gonna be. I also wanna be able to impact this output right here. Like, I can access this only by looking at a roll-up of the price. So I find that we get a little bit more flexibility by building this not in a sub-items field, but instead break this out into its own new table. So that's what I want to start with. I'm just going to go with items here, and I'll start from scratch. I'll name it items. And of course, SmartSuite gives us these default fields, which I don't need for this one. So I'm going to clear them, and I'm going to get into my title here and say that I don't require it to be unique. Just toggle those things off. So what do I need for an item? Well, it's gonna link to an order. So let's go with a linked record here to orders. Make sure that we're looking at orders, and each item that we add is only gonna link to one. So I'm gonna rename this to be orders. So each new item that we add to an order, of course, is gonna include the item itself. So I can use the text here and I'll call this item. It's also going to have a quantity. So this is the number that we sold, right? So we're gonna use a number field. I don't need decimals for this. So we'll go to the precision of the whole number, and I'll rename this to be quantity. And we're also going to include the actual price per unit. This will be a currency field type. Let's go with price per unit. And then lastly, I'm going to compute the subtotal. This will be with a formula, simple enough on the formula, right? Let's rename this to be subtotal. And I don't even need to go into the advanced editor. I can simply say price per unit multiplied by the quantity. Simple enough. add that field. So now, if instead of using the data that we started with, and actually let me reorder my tables, items are going to be right after orders because they follow the orders. Rather than bringing in all of these sub items, I can actually just ditch these entirely, delete that field altogether. And you can see that we have some fields here on the order, like shipping field, tax, discount. What I'm trying to affect here is updating this subtotal. I don't want this to be a free-floating number. I want it to be calculated so that we never have to worry about it being the wrong amount. So now that we have our items set up here, let's now link them to our orders, which we've done here, and I can start adding in some information. So let's suppose that we sold thing one. We sold four of it. They're $100 each. You'll see the subtotal calculate in a moment. And I've got thing two. Maybe we sold two of these and they're $150 each. So this is specifically for order one. Now I can go into the title and auto-generate it now that I filled out my other fields. Yes, I understand. And I'm going to just include the order number and a dash and then the item itself. So let's bring in the item element. And that should be good enough. Let's update the field. So here we go. So we can see that we sold thing one on order one. We sold four of them. This is the subtotal. Great. Let's go back into orders now. We're going to take our subtotal here and change this field. So I'm going to actually insert a field to the right. It will be a formula field type. And we're going to roll up that information. And I'll call this subtotal with an asterisk because I can't have two fields named the same thing. We'll go into advanced editor here. And I want to do a sum on the subtotals that are connected here. So I need to see the items. I'm looking at my link to items dot subtotal, and I am summing all of the subtotals for each item linked to every order. Let's go ahead and add this field. Now you will notice, and this is something that is coming soon, that SmartSuite does not yet allow us to format this formulaic output. It's going 700.00. If you want to add a dollar sign and things like that, you'll need to do it manually inside of your formula. But shortly, I am hopeful that they will allow us to include the formatting here on this so that I can say, hey, this is a currency output. But now that we have this, we can ditch our subtotal. This field is no longer relevant. And that's going to break actually our total formula because our total formula needs to add our subtotal. So let's get rid of this and make sure to include our new subtotal field plus our shipping plus our tax minus any discounts. Let's take a look. Now we should see it calculating properly. So this is great. This is the first step. I've got my orders linked to items. And of course, my invoices are bringing in all the information here from my orders. So now it's time to build our invoice. So here inside of the table where we want the invoice to be generated, in this case is my invoices table, we go down from the table, we click on the table itself, go down to Document Designer, and we've already started this document. You can see that I bring in here the invoice number, and I'm bringing in the customer, and I'm also bringing in the order date. All of this information is either living in my invoices table or I have the ability to look it up and bring it in. But what I want to do now is actually on my left-hand panel, I want to access the data that's associated with my order. So inside of my order, I can see this is order two, and here are the different fields. I can choose to show these things in a table, a list, or in just a single record. Well, I want to include my items, and because my items aren't directly linked to my invoices, it's going to cause us a little bit of a hiccup right now. Because if I look at items right now, I'm seeing them through the link to orders. So here I am, I see the link to items, but I don't see that information on the order table, right? So if I'm looking at this, it's going to list out all my different links, but it's two layers deep because I have invoices connecting to orders, which connect to items. And this is going to cause a bit of a problem for us. So let's actually back out of this. And in order to just save ourselves some steps, let's go and build this in our orders table instead. I can go into my document designer and create a new one. Now, here I can bring in all the information that lives here, like, for example, the customer. This is a link to the customer, so you can see that by default, it's giving us all the information about the customer in a table. But if I switch it over to single, it's just going to show me the customer name. I can update this, right? I can make it wider, taller, you know, adjust how I want it to show up. I can position it absolutely or make it relative in terms of if I have multiple pieces of data, maybe it gets longer or is adjusting. And I can also anchor it to previous elements inside of my final output. So here I'm just going to list out the customer. Let's make this as simple as possible. I'll bring in the order ID as well. Let's drop this up here. I can also make these things larger, change the font, change the height, etc., the alignment, you know, all the things you would expect in a typical document designer. So I've got my invoice. I've got it for the customer. Maybe I'm also going to bring in the order date. Let's see what dates I have. Here we go. Bring in an order date up here. But most importantly, I want those line items. So here's my link to line items. I'm going to drop it in. I don't want the title here. I don't even want the description. What I want to see is the item, the different elements that we added, right? Here, I want to see the item itself. I want to see the number or the quantity sold. And I want to see the price per unit. And lastly, I want to see the subtotal. So I can drop this in just like that. I now have a nice little table that is displaying this information. I can also drop it into a list, as I mentioned, or just do single information, which doesn't help us here. We want to go line by line and display all of this. And you'll note that depending on how many different items we've linked to, this is going to be longer or shorter. But now what I want to get to is how do I anchor the sum here? So I've got my list of things that we're selling, but I need to get to my other elements that we're adding here. Number one, we have tax. So let's bring in our tax and set it right here. Now, this list before here, remember, could be five items long, could be one. So in order to keep this from looking wonky, we are going to need to anchor it. We can do that here. Now, quick note, when we do this, by default, it goes up to the top. We don't want that. We have to choose what we're anchoring it to. We're anchoring it to the list of line items. And you can see now it's going to pop down at the bottom of that list of line items. And I can also add to this, you know, the tax. If I wanted to just say tax in front of there, I could add that extra verbiage. Next, I need my shipping because we have a shipping fee. Similarly, I need to anchor this. But an important note is once you've anchored one thing in your doc, you're going to need to anchor everything else to the thing before it. Otherwise, it's going to really look weird. So here I am. I need to anchor this now to my tax. Let's get it over there so that it's in the appropriate spot. All right, we're going anchor to tax. Distance from anchor, we can update. So if we want a little bit more space here, we can do that just like so. And then lastly, I need to add in my discount. Let's drop this over here. This is anchored. Again, this time we're going to anchor it to the thing above it, which was the shipping fee. I can add some distance if I want to space it out. And then one more thing is going to be our total. Subtotal in this case. Let's bring the subtotal in. And actually, it kind of makes a little more sense to have the subtotal here underneath the list and then add the additional fees. So let me actually bump this in. Let me include this here. I'm going to anchor it to the link to line items, and then everything else is going to have to get anchored down. So this is going to get anchored to the subtotal, and now that moves everything down. Now I'd like to put a little more space here. It's going to just look a little cleaner. So here we go. I've got my subtotal calculating in my document. I've got 400 and 300. Here's my subtotal. Here's my tax. Here is my shipping fee. Here is my discount, if any. And then lastly, finally, let's get to our total, our actual total. We're going to drop it in, add it right here, and we're going to anchor it. Remember, once we've anchored one thing, we need to anchor everything else to the thing above it. Let's add some distance there so that it looks a little better. Let's up the font, let's embolden it, and now we have all the relevant information. All right, you can make this a lot prettier. You can add logos, you can add images, but this is the basics. Now that we have our design here, we're going to save it, and we can look at that design easily from the orders table at any point in time. Just go to the document designer if we need to go back in. This is called new document. We could rename it if we wanted to invoice. And we can just flip through here on a preview and see, look, here's item or invoice one. We sold these things, thing one, thing two, this many, this price, this subtotal, all the different fees, the end. But we don't want to create this manually. This is the exciting part, creating this document automatically. So let's build a new field here, and I'll just make it a Boolean yes, no field. and I'll say create document for the name. And so when this thing is toggled on to yes, that is going to be the trigger that initiates our automation. And then I'm going to store that document in a file field type, and I'll call this invoice as, and let's add the field. All right, so now what I want to have happen is when I push that button, we're going to create the document with an automation and drop it back in our attachment field. Let's get started. Inside of SmartSuite, without ever leaving the solution, I've now put in my data, I've put together my document, and I'm going to build my automation. So we're going to say when a record matches conditions, that is in our orders table, yes, we're going to say that we are looking for the create doc to be equal to yes. When that happens, we will then initiate our automation. What are we going to do? And it's right here, my friends, generate PDF. Now, we can generate the PDF from the template that we created in the orders table. Give it just a moment. And so when a record matches the condition in the trigger, that will generate the PDF called invoice. Any templates that you've built in that table will be showing up here. So you can have multiple PDFs. We only have the one. Then we can name this, and we can name it dynamically. This is really helpful because the file we create, we want it to be named something useful. So maybe we want to name it after the customer, which I can include here. And maybe I also want to include the order number. So let's go ORD, find that order ID. And there it is, customer bar order ID. Or let's use a slash just in case. I don't want to use any fancy characters. So this will then create the PDF, but we're not done. We want to do something with that PDF. Let's add it back into our record. Let's update the record that triggered the automation. Now we have to choose what information we're going to update. And of course, all we want to do is add that newly created PDF to the record. So we named that field invoices, plural. This is our attachment field. And you can see if we go back to fields from trigger, these are the fields from the trigger. This is using data from an action where we generated a PDF, and that's what we want. When we generate the PDF in this step, we want to click into that and take the exported PDF from that particular automation step and put it back in our table, right? Save that automation, and let's now go ahead and run this thing. I've got this here. I'm going to check it off and recheck it, which will rerun our automation. We're gonna pause here and wait for the automation to do its work. Less than 5 seconds go by, and now we have a PDF in our invoices table, just like that. You'll notice that it's named after the customer and the order, which is perfect. That's how we named the PDF. And I can drill in here and take a look at the PDF, all the information showing up appropriately. If I add additional line items, if I make changes to this, I can just easily uncheck this and check it again, create through automation a brand new PDF, drop it right back here, and I can even email it to my customer in my automation as well. I know we went pretty fast here, so any questions we didn't quite get to, feel free to drop them below. And if you have more advanced needs, swing by our website. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did, please give us a thumbs up. But most importantly, in the meantime, keep on building.